As we gather together tonight in the sight of the Lord and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, we celebrate with them the love that they have for each other. And we also celebrate today the love that God has for us. I'm reminded what the scripture says when God says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in him should not perish." I don't know of a greater example that we have on this earth of God's love for us than that of the union of a man and a woman and the love that they have for each other. And God most certainly loves us and cares for us. And God gave us a spouse, a person that would be our soulmate, that we could share that love with each other. So we appreciate what the Lord has done for us in giving us the institution of marriage. The scripture says, from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. And the Lord God said that it's not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helpmeet for him. And for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife. And they twain shall be in one flesh. I'm reminded also of what happens when we accept Christ as our Savior, that he becomes a part of us. And we leave the things of the world. His bride. As the scripture goes on to say that they are no more twain but one flesh. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife see that she loveth her husband. You, Sean, and you, Julie, accompany me, signifying your desire to be formally united in marriage, and being assured that no legal, moral, or religious barriers hinder this proper union, I now command you, as you already have, to join your right hand and give to me the questions now asked. Sean, in taking the woman whom you hold by the right hand to be your lawful and wedded wife, I require you to promise to love and cherish her, to honor and sustain her, in sickness and in health, in poverty as in wealth, in the bad that may darken your days, in the good that may lighten your ways, and to be true to her and to, in all things, until death alone shall part you. Do you so promise? Julie, in taking the man who holds you by the right hand to be your lawful and wedded husband, I require you to promise to love and cherish him, to honor and sustain him, in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, in the bad that may darken your days, in the good that may lighten your ways, and to be true to him in all things until death alone shall part you. Be you so promised. A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. Love suffereth long and is kind. Love envieth not. Love vaunteth not itself, it's not puffed up. Does not behave itself unseemly. It seeks not her own. It's not easily provoked. It does not think evil. It rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopeth all things. It endures all things. Love never fails, for love is of God. And now abideth faith, hope, and love, these three, but the greatest of these is love. And now have one of them. The ring that I hold in my hand placed upon one of their fingers. This ring is a symbol of love. The reason it's a symbol of love is because it's a never-ending circle and continues, and like love should continue. Its unending circle represents the eternal quality of your love, and the gold represents the purity of that love. As a ceaseless reminder of this hour and the seal of the vows that you take, you will now give and Do you, Julie, give this ring to Sean as a token of your love for him? Would you please repeat after me? I, Julie, take thee, Sean, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my love. Will you, Sean, take this ring as a token of Julie's love for you, and will you wear it as a token of your love for her? I shall take me to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold death do us part. To death do us part. According to God's holy word. According to God's holy word. And thereto, will you duly take this ring as a token of Sean's love for you? And will you wear it as a token of your love for him? And in that place to rest. Heavenly Father, we pray today your greatest blessing upon us. Lord, we are so thankful today. So thankful, God, that you love us. Thankful, Lord, that you were willing to send your Son, Jesus Christ, into this world to die for our sins. And Lord, today we celebrate that love. We celebrate that love in our personal lives, and we celebrate that love today, dear Father, as this union is taking place in Sean and you. I pray, Lord, that you would bless them now as a family. I pray, Lord, that you would watch over them, that you would provide for them. And Lord, that most of all today, you would guide them. I pray, Lord, that they would stay true to you, close to you, throughout the rest of their lives. I pray, Lord, your blessing upon their children, their grandchildren. And Lord, may when their children and grandchildren look at them, they'll see a perfect example of what true love really should be. I pray, Lord, for strength upon this marriage. I pray, Lord, that it would last. Lord, today, bless them. The Bible says, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. These words which I command thee this day shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently unto your children, shall talk of them when you sit in your house. Put on, therefore, as the elect of God, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, and long-suffering, forbearing one another and forgiving one another. And above all these, put on love, which is the bond of perfection. Let the peace of God rule in your hearts, having pledged your faith in and love to each other, having sealed your solemn marital vows by giving and receiving the rings, acting in the authority vested in me by the laws of this state, looking to heaven for divine sanction, I pronounce you husband and wife in the presence of God and his assembled witnesses. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. And now may the God of peace prosper and bless you in this new relationship. And may the grace of Jesus Christ abound in you now and forevermore. Sean, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Sean McGee.
Let's get on some. Get your people in here.
Switch spots.
Your people.
Hey,
Larry, get your people.
First cousins. There, Shannon, come on.
All about on family.
Thanks.
Yeah, well, thank you. They got babies.
Nice to go in there.
Warren, Terry.
I think you're in. Spouses.
Corey, Jamie.
We can edit it out. We'll edit
it. Look at there.
Bye,
Donnie. One.
Two. Look right here, Shannon.
We got the dog in it.
Grace. Sydney! Sydney!
It doesn't matter. I'm not getting him. One, two, three. I think my babies are looking this way. One more. Everybody just smile, okay? One, two. Look right at me. Three. Look here. One more. It's a lot of people. One, two, three. Okay.